John, it's the second budget that the Liberal government has tabled in this Trump era and in this era of uncertain international climate. Could they have done more in this budget?
Well, I think they spent so much money last year, there wasn't a lot of leeway for them to spend a whole lot more. But I think they have been more cautious than they might have been, maybe because of Trump. But there are things that that some of us were expecting, some cuts to tax credits, some more spending here and there, that might have had a political cost. And they haven't done them. And I think it's a pretty thin budget, pretty cautious budget. From the point of view of somebody who's a fiscal conservative, that to me is a good thing. But I think there'll be a lot of disappointed people there. There's not much news in this thing.
You've called it a thin budget. Is it safe to say that this is the budget that maybe clarified the 2016 budget?
Yes, I think that's right. I mean, basically the 2016 budget allocated billions and billions and billions of dollars for infrastructure. Today we're finding out where some of the detail, where that money is going to be spent.
So I want to get into the minutiae of it. Dissect some of it for me. What are some of the things that really stick out for you?
Well, they spend an awful lot of time on innovation. The word innovation appears more than 200 times. There are lots of little...
You went through that book that thoroughly.
Well, we've got a little secret software which... which uncovers the how many times the word is used. But of course, subsidy is never used. The word investment is used. I think that the problem for this government, as with all other governments, is that they want to increase the amount of business investment. So they want companies to spend more on research and development. Every Canadian government tries to do that. None of them have particularly succeeded. We spend a lot of money on research and development in universities. Companies don't tend to spend that money. Every government tries to figure out why. Nobody's quite cracked it. And it really, the issue is that we're right next to the US, we're a resource economy, and companies don't feel the need to spend a lot of R&D.
Now, I want to make sure I get this right, because this is the same narrative as last year, building a strong middle class.
Yeah, well, it's the narrative they use. They claim that the middle class tax cut they introduced last year has made those who benefit an average of $330 better off. That's those who benefit. If you don't benefit of all taxpayers, we do not all come out $330 better off. It's a little bit of a play on words, and in fact it looks like that the most people will not have felt the benefit of the middle class tax cut. They may have felt the benefit of the child credit, which is a huge number. It was a campaign promise. It probably helped them win the election, and it ends up with it, if you have a kid, then you're probably much better off, because it's a total of $20 billion. Of course, the other side of that coin is that if you don't have a child, you're probably not better off. And for all the talk of the middle class, most taxpayers haven't noticed any difference from the tax cuts they've made.